Hi guys, welcome to my channel. For those that are new, my channel is about colored pencil art. And for those that have been here before, welcome back. So today's video is going to be about the solvent that I use to blend. I used to use Art Spectrum odorless solvent a lot, but I've sort of transitioned into a product that I think is a lot better. So the product is called Zested Pencil Blend, and the bottle looks like this. And it's a nice little bottle, and it's got one of those safety caps on the top. So it is a non-flammable substance, which is what I love the most. Like, most mineral spirits are highly flammable and they're extremely toxic. So this is still a little toxic, but nothing compared to the mineral spirit substances that you get. So if you get this on your skin, you can just, it'll may cause some dryness. So you'd obviously make sure you moisturize and wash your hands with water. If you accidentally splash a little in your eyes, the same thing, thoroughly wash it out with water. So it's not crazy toxic, and it has quite a pleasant smell. So it does smell very citrusy, and I still find the smell a little bit strong, so I do try and keep the cap closed at all times, and it's only open during the time that I am using it. So today's video is just to show you how I use my pencil blend. And the three products that I use together is obviously the pencil blend, a little brush, which is what I use for the blending, and then I like to use a paper towel so that I can just dab off any of the excess solvent before I apply it to my drawing paper. So I'm going to show you an example on my paper over here. I have a couple of pencils that I am going to use just to create a few layers of color on my paper before I apply the pencil blend. So I'm just going to create a simple sort of square with some light layers of pencil. So I'm going to try and make this video really short and sweet, because I tend to be a perfectionist in the sense that I always want to show something in as much detail as possible. But the sake of this video is purely to show you how I use the pencil blend and nothing else. And of course, what product I use. Okay. So let's pretend that this is a highly detailed drawing and I've done a couple of my layers of colored pencils and now I want to blend it with my solvent. So all I'm going to do is, this has a safety cap, so to open it you just have to press down. So press the cap down, open it up, and then I just dip a little bit of, or dip the tip of my brush into it, and then I take my paper towel and dab off any excess. I think I dabbed off a little bit too much. And then I will go ahead and blend in my colored pencil. The beauty about using solvent like this is that it takes away that crayon look of your paper, and the texture of the paper doesn't come through. It makes the entire area look really, really smooth. And that's the biggest thing about colored pencils, is a lot of people don't like using them because the process of blending is not known to them, I guess. So a lot of people use pressure to blend, and I don't like using pressure to blend because I have very weak wrists, so the burnishing technique is definitely not a favorite of mine. So this is just a really simple, effective way to blend and layer. So the beauty about this as well is that it allows you to layer multiple layers of colors, whereas if you're burnishing, you are very limited to the amount of layers you can put down on your paper. So that looks really, really smooth, and that is pretty much just how I use my pencil blend. Now I can, once that's dry, so while it's wet, you can see a little bit of the discoloration in the paper around the area that I just blended. That will dry and go away, so you won't see that once it's all dry. But once it is dry, I am able to layer more layers of colored pencil over the top, and it does really well. And then I can blend it again if I choose to. So that is just a short and sweet video of what I use to blend my colored pencils and how I blend my colored pencils. All you need is a odorless solvent, a small brush, and a paper towel, and you're ready to go. Oh, and this is for wax and oil-based pencils. You can't use this on watercolor pencils. It's predominantly for things that are not water soluble. Okay, so that is it for today's video. I hope that's useful. A lot of people ask me about the solvent that I use, and now you know this is what I use and this is the basic ways that I use it. So thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye!